The aftermath of Egghead Island had both Aokiji and Kizaru in the doghouse. No pun intended, and of course, Red Dog, I know the jokes write themselves, but with their own respective party leaders, the final villain candidates in Blackbeard, who kind of allowed Aokiji's failure to keep Kobe and Moria captured, the failure of that because of the consolation prize of Garp being captured, and then of course, the final villain candidate in Akainu, who pretty much got yelled at for Kizaru's performance, like pretty much was going off on Kizaru, yelling at Kizaru, and then that got him in turn yelled at when Kizaru completed his mission and killed his own best friend, something that Akainu couldn't do during the time skip versus Aokiji. All in all, Akainu apologized, and it sparked an age-old question that, let's be honest here, it's been around for over past a decade, yo, since a while. Who is stronger, Kuzan or Borsalino? Both of them come in climbing up the marine ranks at the same time with Akainu, and now Monkey D. Dragon, who confirmed recently his marine ties, and of course is the same age, around the same age as Akainu and Kizaru, or around that ballpark, where Aokiji is the youngest of the group, and the Phenom, who got nominated to be Fleet Admiral by Sengoku, the former Fleet Admiral. Who would have thought the youngest of the group would be nominated to be Fleet Admiral in the future? And then, of course, all in all, this is not going to be as toxic as Miyak versus Shanks, which is, I'll dive in that in another video for another day. If this video gets 1,000 likes, I'll do the Miyak Shanks video, but I'm telling you guys right now, the comments, you guys are not going to be happy to read those comments. So make sure you guys, of course, like and subscribe as we do a deep dive on Aokiji versus Kizaru, because it's more deeper than you think. Aokiji got introduced in the story as the Marine's strongest power, known as the Admirals, with, of course, Robin even explaining there are more individuals on the same level as him, even name-dropping Kizaru and Akainu, the Yellow Monkey and the Red Dog, and now the Blue Pheasant. Aokiji low-key fell into the trap as the first to be shown. It's usually the weakest in the group in anime tropes, with just recently in Egghead Island, Saturn being eliminated first as the Dorsey and getting replaced by Figel and Garling into the group. Now, whether Saturn was the weakest or not doesn't matter. The fact that he got taken out, he was the jobber of the group, and we know everyone could mention how Aokiji got taken out of the Marines, so could he have been the jobber? All in all, when it comes to, of course, we looked at Mercury, Venus, Juro, and Mars all showing better feats than Saturn, but there are cases like Miyak, who was the first warlord, or Shanks, who was the first Yonko, that break that famous anime trope. So it does give hope that Aokiji fans, he is not the weakest of the original Admirals. But that aside, his performance was amazing, from using his powers to freeze the sea creature. And he looked like a good guy, which, him being good or bad, is all depending on how you view him and his marine stance and now his pirate stance. And of course, pretty much low diffing Luffy, Zoro, and Sanji with ease. They're fresh off their Alabasta wins, with Zoro getting his first bounty. And then of course, yeah, Aokiji goes and just destroys them. And then destroys Luffy, and only keeps him alive because of Garp's relationship with Aokiji, which was explored later on in the series. Of course, Garp actually training Aokiji, Aokiji being his protege. When you look at it more at a deeper stance, Aokiji is the reason why Gear 5th Luffy exists, as Luffy recognized he needed to be stronger and developed Gear 2nd and Gear 3rd versus Rob Lucci. So yeah, Aokiji's intro was definitely one of the more that meets the eye situation. Shout out to Transformers. Now, Kizaru's intro was a little different, but still revolved around the Straw Hat Pirates, and that is what really matters. Oda did this on purpose for us to compare the two admirals, with Kizaru starting off by defeating the Mad Monk Rouge, the only supernova post time skip we haven't included in an arc, and the man who took down Snack, one of the Big Mom's top commanders. He also defeated Scratchman Apu, who got a hit on him. That was pretty cool of Apu, and cut him up, only of course for Kizaru to flex his Logia ability and speed of obliterating him, and then former Rear Admiral X-Drake, who knows about Kizaru's powers, and Kaido's Flying Six member, who really is the leader of S.W.O.R.D. X-Drake is an ancient Zoan, so for Kizaru to destroy him was extra cool, and then of course finish off Hall of Hawkins' extra lives. Yeah, so that's pretty cool to force supernova captains to be defeated like that without taking any damage is fucking wild. And then of course tried to kill Zoro right after, who was of course weakened, but then Silver's Rayleigh came and saved the day, where Kizaru took a cut to his cheek trying to of course finish the job and really stopped him, and then had to focus fully on Rayleigh, who was sweating though. So people say, yo, Rayleigh was sweating during the fight. That is crazy. And people say Kizaru recognized Rayleigh's power and said, I couldn't be able to take you down. All in all, we know it was a close fight between these two individuals, and Kizaru's intro was cooler and made him look pretty powerful, the fact that he fought stronger characters than Aokiji. Now, I think what really made this argument really confusing was Marineford War. I know a lot of the power scaling goes back to this war, pretty times give the war the best, what a name. And when Aokiji during Marineford had some crazy ups and downs, let's talk about it. He started the war off by freezing Whitebeard's tsunami and attacking him with frozen arrows, only for Whitebeard to quake it, and Aokiji got sent to the ocean where he frozen, and which would set the Marineford battle grand. And then we saw Aokiji try to kill Luffy, but Marco came in the picture and kicked him out of the way, which led to the question, is Aokiji the Sanji of the Admirals? Because he was fighting Jozu, and Kizaru was fighting Marco, and Akainu was fighting Whitebeard. All in all, Aokiji would show his advanced armor haki alongside the Admirals, showing that they are still legit. The Admirals were still a tier of their own, blocking Whitebeard's quake attack, and then of course attack Whitebeard again and freeze him, but Whitebeard broke out with his quakes. Then we saw Aokiji use advanced osmation haki or future sight, not confirmed, but we can assume because Black Katakuri did, by putting a hole in the area Whitebeard attacked with haki and stabbed him with haki. But then Aokiji got sneaked attacked by Jozu and made him draw blood. And that's the thing, no other admiral drew blood to a Yonko commander before this happened, and that was the crazy part. Jozu earlier blocked, now to defend Aokiji, like, I'm gonna keep it real, this would be an L normally for an admiral, but level character, but Jozu earlier blocked Miyok's sword slash, and then of course made Crocodile bleed with an attack of his own, which Crocodile mentioned his speed and power. But then some people say, yo, Doflamingo had Jozu stuck in those traps. At the end of the day, you have to understand this. We know what Jozu's capable of when it comes to his ability and power, and diamond being just naturally such a strong material. I will say this, I'll cut Aokiji some slack, especially since he defeated Jozu and took an arm. Let's be honest here. Some people might say, even though an arm was taken, this may be argued as a sneak attack because Jozu was distracted, of course, of Whitebeard getting sick and being down the count during that moment. Even Marco got distracted, but that's the part of the pirate battle. So I'm gonna give Aokiji an up and a very shaky W in defeating Jozu. Now, of course, Kizaru during Marineford also started off by attacking Whitebeard, but Marco the Phoenix, the first division commander, blocked the attack. Mind you, Marco's the same guy who fought King and Queen during the Onigashima raid. So Marco is one of those unique vice captain to Yonkos, even fought Blackbeard, and that's what Blackbeard got catapulted to, of course, Yonko status by defeating Marco. So yeah, Marco definitely makes Kizaru look good, the fact that he's fighting him during Marineford. Now, I do want to say this, and then he kicked Kizaru to the ground, and then we seen Kizaru get Vice Admiral Onigashima to use his Dull Fruit ability to lock up Marco with Sea Prism Stone and start lasering him. So we also seen Kizaru also kick the shit out of Luffy in this moment and made fun of Whitebeard for having trash lead his vanguard, his squad. And then of course he finally shot some lasers at Whitebeard, though Whitebeard was very injured and the speed wasn't the best, fighting the most fastest guy in the series. We later saw Whitebeard slash him when he tried to go for Luffy from getting to Ace. All in all, Kizaru never really had a clear-cut W or a clear-cut L like Aokiji during Marineford. It was just a regular performance, unless we mention him putting his hands up to Ben Beckman, a vice captain to a Yonko, when he's an admiral. Isn't a good look. Ben Beckman is a special case though, because Brand, you said the Red Air Pirates have extremely powerful pirate crew. And of course, Ben Beckman is the strongest under Shanks. I must admit, Greenbolt did say, though, it will be a bad look for the Admirals to lose the Yonko Commanders, which he's right. Though I do want to say this, end of story, the Pirate King Commanders will be the ones to defeat the Admirals. All in all, Kizaru still attacked Lost Ship right after Ben Beckman's threat. But as fans, perception is reality, and this was left a bad look for Kizaru going into the time skip, with pretty much a decent performance at Marineford. Now, post-time skip, we knew Aokiji lost to Akainu after 10 days, meaning him and Akainu were relatively around the same level, and it made sense with their powers, ice and magma, though we always said Akainu was the strongest admiral, meaning for Kizaru to be above Aokiji, you would have to actually be above Akainu, which only so little fans actually wouldn't want to hop on that train. And then we had, of course, Aokiji freezing Doflamingo, and his crew, Buffalo and Baby Fire, were so happy that Doflamingo wasn't frozen to the core, because it would have been game over for him. And then, of course, that's how he saved Smoker, and Smoker questioned him about his underworld tactics and connections. And then a film Z revealed, of course, he lost his leg to Akainu, so that also changed a little bit of our thoughts on, of course, that battle during the time skip. So, of course, we were thinking, is he nerfed because he lost his leg? We didn't know, but it was later be revealed. Even the Gorosei were worried about Aokiji being connected to Blackbeard, and they were right, because after witnessing the Egghead Island arc, which had him go toe-to-toe, first of all, before going toe-to-toe with Garp. We saw him in Hulking Island and Kidnap Pudding by one-shotting Cracker. The anime made it look extremely well. Then we had Aokiji fight Monkey D. Garp with the help of the other Blackbeard pirates. And even though Aokiji won with the help, one thing I noticed is they highlighted his training under Garp, which was about physical raw power, not durability, not haki, which we rarely see in the story. And then of course we've seen right after that his haki clash with Garp, which was cool feat knowing Garp is a haki specialist. All in all, Aokiji's power is underrated, and it only made Akainu look more scary when we see him fight too. But also made us think maybe we should be comfortable putting Aokiji above Kizaru. Now when it comes to post time skip, they were teasing us Kizaru's greatness by having him wanting to go to Wano after Big Mom and Kaido were about to clash, showing he had no fear of the Yonko. And then they had him go to Egghead Island. And Akainu said, don't let Lucci fight against Luffy until Kizaru shows up. Starting off the Kizaru versus Monkey D. Luffy. It's funny because Aokiji fought Monkey D. Garp, and then of course Kizaru fights his grandson Monkey D. Luffy. It's like Oda did this on purpose because we all know that Akainu, the strongest pre-time skip, I don't know, is gonna fight Monkey D. Dragon. I know, I'm just another theory for you guys. I thought I'd give you guys a little sneak peek. Sometimes you gotta add in the middle of random videos, guys. But let's actually get back to the topic at hand. And this, of course, battle would end the famous Yonko versus Admiral argument that's older than the channel I'm making itself, which is crazy. And yes, Kizaru completed his mission of killing Vegapunk, but when the fight begins with Kizaru blocking Luffy's Conqueror's Haki kick, and then we see Snake Man fighting, and Kizaru says, now I know how you beat Kaido, only for Gear 5 to come out of nowhere and really show how he beat Kaido, and Luffy making him not move with one punch to the skull. Yeah, Gear 5 was crazy. And then Luffy grabbing him and Sanada at the same time, squeezing them together, playing with his food, while of course throwing them back to the sea. And just Kizaru laying down exhausted after that ass whooping. It was insane. Yes, Kizaru was purposely not going down for the count because he was done. His mission was complete. He's not going to fight Luffy. He didn't come here to fight Luffy. People might as well add Sanji blocking Kizaru's laser beam. And of course, that also making Kizaru look bad in this arc. Interesting. I just seen this as Kizaru versus Sanji foreshadowing at the end of the story. All in all, we got a lot of answers shown after Egghead Island with, of course, the age-old debate of Aokiji versus Kizaru. And kind of where my clear-cut answer goes, and you guys might not be happy. I personally had Kizaru stronger than Aokiji pre-time skip, just of what I'm shown. Like, I'm not going to do a lot of theorizing when it comes to power scaling. But after I heard about the Punk Hazard situation, and also Sengoku nominating Aokiji for Fleet Admiral, and then of course his training under Garp, which people are definitely not talking about enough, this only confirmed to me Oda wants us to look at Aokiji above Kizaru. And yes, Kizaru's power looks more deadly, especially when you realize speed is also power, but it looks like Aokiji can of course tank way more attacks. His raw power seems to be above Kizaru as well. All this debate just makes me excited to see Final Saga Akainu throwing hands. And I also have to mention Aokiji being more prominent in the story, being on that famous claim, the One Piece page we just seen with the Yonko, Akainu, Dragon, etc. All I want to say is this: watch my Monster Trio video to see how strong they are before Elbaf and how they're strong they'll be after Elbaf. And yeah, that's my answer. I think Aokiji is stronger than Kizaru. If you disagree with me, put it in the comment section. Let me hear it.